Today we're going to be talking about Call of Duty World War 2. Should you buy it, or you should be acting like Fernando and say don't buy Call of Duty World War 2 because hey, it's going to contain memes. But for real though, we're going to deep dive into it. I will point out a couple of things, the content we're going to be getting, and we're also going to go through campaign, multiplayer, zombies, and something more exclusive that will be coming this year for zombie. Yes, oh, there's a lot of hype, did you know? But we're going to get into all of that in just a little bit, and this video may change your perception. It may make you not wanting to buy the game, or it will make you want to buy the game like right now if you weren't planning on to buy, which is a good thing in my opinion. But by the end of this video, let me know if you are gonna buy, on what console, so maybe we can hook up, you know what I'm saying? Are you all about PC Master Race, or you're just wanting to go for Bob on Christmas and get his ass down? Let me know. And like always, if you do end up subscribing, let me know that too in the comments so I can just put you in my next video. But we're gonna jump in first with the campaign, and it's safe to say it's not gonna have any memes. Like, trust me, I'm gonna put my right and left foot forward at the same time, no breaks at all. I'm gonna say it's gonna have zero memes. The campaign of World War II is gonna have surely the true World War II story. The swastikas are gonna be there because a lot of people were female dogging about. I cannot use the real word. You guys know what I'm saying. Gotta stay kids friendly, right? And we're also gonna have the hollow, you know what I'm saying? But we're also gonna be saying the ADOL. You guys get what I'm saying. Like, it hit. you know what I'm saying? We haven't seen him in the trailer yet, but I'm pretty sure he's gonna be present in the campaign, and that's gonna be a monumental event. And I'm pretty sure he's probably gonna be present in the last mission of the campaign and be saying like, what? And I'll be looking at him and saying like, what? And Bob will be looking at him and saying like, what? But honestly, we're all talking about video games, that's why I'm kinda like memeing, but of course, in reality, that shit was pretty effed up. I'm not gonna lie. But the campaign is that's one piece of content, and there's a lot of rumors flying around that after you finish up the campaign, we're gonna unlock something for zombies, and that something is pretty huge. We're gonna get to that when we get to the zombies part. And a lot of people don't play the campaign, they just want to buy the game for multiplayer, but at the same time they want to get the campaign. They're like, I pay $60, and if you're like me, hey, I will be paying $80 because I'm in Canada. So that's that. A lot of people are like, I want to get the campaign even though they're not gonna play, because they want to get the most out of their buck, and that's probably not a bad meme. So that's that. And this time around, I genuinely want to play the campaign because, oh, that mother effer is looking pretty badass, I'm not gonna lie. So that's that, and I'm assuming a lot of people will be playing the campaign one day or another. But now we're gonna be talking about multiplayer, which is the bread and butter of Call of Duty. It's super crucial. Of course, zombies is crucial at the same time, and it seems like zombies has surely overtaken the multiplayer side of things, but this time they are coming back with a banger, and they're gonna hit us hard because we already have played the beta, we already have formed our opinions. I surely have, and from me, I really enjoyed the beta. I think it's gonna be a banger, right? We're most likely gonna get 10 maps at launch for multiplayer, 3 of which we already played in the beta. There was a city map that a lot of people didn't like, but that was my personal favorite. I don't know about you, but that was my personal favorite. So far, I'm gonna say that for sure. The snow map was a really solid map, and the last one wasn't my favorite, but it was good as well. And I really have a good vibe because they are going for that variety, which is good in my opinion, because what map you like at first may not stay that way, and you may end up liking the map that you hated at first, which is awesome, right? The guns seem to be really solid, they look real. That's probably one of the crucial part, and they absolutely nailed it. The papoosh, oh, absolutely love that gun, but the sound is not that good at the same time for the papoosh, because I'm comparing that to Call of Duty World at War. But at the same time, I don't want to complain, because this time around we're getting something really, really good. The gameplay is smooth as well, and that's all that matters. And now we're gonna be talking about zombies, and then we're gonna finalize our thoughts, and we're gonna look at things, and we're gonna be like, hey, should you buy the game or should you not? Because zombies is definitely crucial. I am more of a zombies fan. I used to actually just play multiplayer. My first Call of Duty was Call of Duty Black Ops 1. With that, I got introduced to zombies, but I wasn't really a big fan of zombies. I used to love this thing called Kino Der Toten. I played that shit. I was like Bob. And now I am really, really good at zombies, but at the same time, I really do suck ass at zombies. But what I'm saying here is that I used to be a huge multiplayer guy. I play shitloads of Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. I banged that shit, you know what I'm saying? I also banged that Black Ops 2 multiplayer, you know what I'm saying? But after that, Call of Duty went downhill for me, at least the multiplayer side of things. I became more of a zombies guy and absolutely loved every second of zombies. But in Infinite Warfare Zombies, I personally enjoyed that. A lot of people didn't, but at the same time, it's like Infinite Warfare Zombies wasn't the best, but it wasn't the worst as well. I personally haven't played DLC 4 because the gameplay and everything was spoiled for me. I saw the gameplay 5 days before and I was like, hey, I don't really want to play the map, but that doesn't mean the map is bad, but that's just my opinion. So that's where I am with zombies. I love zombies. I played Infinite Warfare Zombies. There were a lot of memes that were like, cash me outside, how about that? That was something that they put in Swallowing Shuffle, and that was like, and when they put in, it was a old meme. So they kind of like started to come in with the old memes. They wanted to kind of like revive old memes, and I was saying like, whoa, you crazy. But at the same time, they really did that. And it's safe to say in Call of Duty World War 2 Zombies, basically the game in general, there aren't going to be any memes. So we have already killed that, and that's a good thing. We also know we're gonna be getting one map at launch, and there are a lot of rumors that after completing the Easter egg, we're gonna get a second map, which will be the same size of Nocturne and Toten. And there are also a lot of hype about the multiplayer, or not the multiplayer, but rather the campaign. Once you finish the campaign, you're gonna unlock something for zombies, maybe a game mode, and that is something that we don't know. Are we going to get multiple game modes for zombies, or is it going to be just survival and co-op? We don't know, but hopefully we do have some new game modes. That's gonna be pretty dope. But after completing the campaign, we're most likely going to get something. There's a lot of hype about it as we speak over on Twitter and everything like that, and a lot of people are like, we're gonna get a second map after completing the Easter egg. And a lot of people are like, hey, we may not get a second map, we may just get an extra kind of like room or area unlocked as a secret room in the first map, which we don't know what it's gonna be called. Army of the Dead, I feel like, but that's just like an army of the dead, or the scientist that is creating, if you know what I'm saying. So that's probably not the name of the map. I feel like it was leaked, but I didn't really look hard at it, so I don't want to talk about any leaks. But after completing the Easter egg, there are rumors that we're gonna unlock a room, and that's sort of like a leak shit, but that's that. And there are also rumors that after completing the campaign, we're gonna unlock something for zombies. I guess time will tell us for sure. And then there's a season pass, which I'm not gonna get into because that's a separate purchase if you're willing, right? So we're not gonna dive into the season pass, but that's that. That's the content we're gonna be getting, and it's gonna be fully packed, I'm pretty damn sure. And there's most likely going to be a secret mode like we have got with Black Ops 3. Hopefully we do. For example, the Nightmare mode, I believe that's what it's called, the Dead Ops, right? I hope we get something like that in Call of Duty World War 2, or maybe if we're not gonna get something like that, hopefully there is depth to zombies. That's what I'm trying to say, and hopefully there's depth to the multiplayer side of things as well. But the question is, should you buy the game or not? And honestly, I would say buy the game if you are a huge fan of Call of Duty, and if you're a huge fan of boots on the ground. I'm not gonna sit here and beat the dead horse and be like, oh, boots on the ground. Of course, we should be getting that like way, way earlier, but of course we're getting it now, so that's awesome. But my biggest complaint is that why aren't they using or making a new engine for Call of Duty? They should be updating their engine. I feel like they do, but they should really rework and make the game much better in terms of the mechanics. Like, look at Battlefield. Like, if you're a huge fan or if you like hate that game, I personally love both games. I enjoy playing both games, and Battlefield is so superior in terms of its mechanics, in terms of the gameplay environments, and there is a lot of depth. And in Call of Duty, there is very minimal depth, but this time around, it looks like it's going to have some depth. Of course, the multiplayer, we're gonna be getting some operations, and that's probably a good start to that. We're also gonna be getting the firing range, which can be awesome as well, like get your squad in and everything like that. But I would say, yes, you should totally buy the game if you're a huge fan of Call of Duty and the World War 2 setting. But if you're looking for memes, there aren't going to be any memes. So if you were looking for memes and you're like, well, Call of Duty must have memes, then this is going to be something that you shouldn't buy. But let me know what you guys think in the comments. Check out some other videos on the screen. Subscribe if you're new. Smash a like, all that sort of stuff. But you don't have to if you don't want to. Only do it if you want to support the channel and me. But I'll see you very freaking soon.